Welcome back to the IBFP. Here's your host, Foxy New.
Welcome to another edition of the Body Bag Series, where we destroy fanboy narratives. Tim the Hater Bradley dares Canelo Alvarez to call out Andre Ward. You know, Tim Bradley did an interview with FightHype.com recently where he came out and tells Canelo Alvarez, hey, beat Andre Ward. That'll show me something. That'll show me you're the great fighter everybody's talking about. Yeah, you can run through undefeated world champions in their prime. Yeah, you can collect belts. Yeah, you can unify, and you may even just go undisputed. But beat Andre Ward. Show me you're great. What the hell is Tim the Hater Bradley talking about? Daring Canelo Alvarez to call out Andre Ward. So Tim Bradley is daring Canelo to call out Andre Ward, saying, hey, beat Andre Ward, like he's some unbeatable monster. If my memory serves correct, I believe Sergey Kovalev was robbed in the first fight against Andre Ward. Let's just be honest and unbiased about it. Not only that, Tim the Hater Bradley is one of the biggest Canelo Alvarez haters there is. It's obvious he can't even hide it anymore. He hates this man is the face of boxing. He's jealous that Canelo Alvarez is the face of boxing. Canelo Alvarez can wipe his ass with every big accomplishment that Tim the Hater Bradley has ever done throughout his entire career. Let's be honest. I mean, look at it like this. Canelo Alvarez is one win away from making history, being undisputed at 168 pounds, doing something no one has ever done at that weight. And you want him to stop what he's doing to call out a retired Andre Ward? Andre Ward, who's retired. Andre Ward, who's 37 years old. These are the same people who didn't want to give Canelo Alvarez credit for beating an active 36-year-old Sergey Kovalev coming off of two wins, who was also a world champion. But Canelo Alvarez should call out and beat Andre Ward, who's older, who's not a champion, and who's not active coming. It doesn't make any sense. These guys will end up making the same excuses, saying, oh, he's old, he's inactive, he's retired. So you can't have it both ways, moron. See, this is what we're talking about with these haters. Haters are never happy. And then we get to Andre Ward himself. Now, Andre Ward has already body bagged this whole theory. He said back in 2019, he does not want the Canelo Alvarez smoke. He wants no smoke with Canelo. He said this years ago. Andre Ward says he will not end his retirement to fight Canelo Alvarez. He's already went on record years ago saying this. This is not my opinion. This is not what I think. This is not how I feel. This is what he said. These are his words. So at the end of the day, Andre Ward has already come out stating that he doesn't want the Canelo Alvarez smoke. Tim the Hater Bradley is looking for anything not to give Canelo Alvarez credit for being great, for being the face of boxing. Tim the Hater Bradley is desperate for anyone, someone, to beat Canelo Alvarez. Haters are getting desperate. I mean, let's be real with it. These guys don't even want the Canelo smoke, and yet Tim the Hater Bradley cannot stop hating. I mean, look at it like this. This is the same Tim the Hater Bradley, you know, who came out and criticized Canelo Alvarez for taking a mandatory fight against Ivani Yildirim, basically saying Canelo Alvarez is not the face of boxing right now. He's not facing the best right now. Ivani Yildirim is a punching bag. Ivani Yildirim is a mandatory opponent. He's a mandatory opponent, you moron. This is the same Bradley who criticized Canelo for taking a mandatory fight in between facing two undefeated world champions. Make that make sense. While he turned around and praised Terrence Crawford for beating a Washkel Brook. This man is absolutely a hater. So Canelo Alvarez fights a mandatory between two undefeated world champions and he's criticized? While Terrence Crawford can face a Washkel Brook? And you praise him? You get on your knees and kiss his ass? What sense does this make? This is the definition of a company man. This man is a clown. Let's be real. This is the same Tim the Hater Bradley who's looking for someone to beat Canelo. He's desperate. He wants him to lose. This is why he was hoping Andre Ward can do it. Before Andre Ward said he didn't want no Canelo smoke. This is the same Tim the Hater Bradley who came out and says, oh, Canelo doesn't want any smoke with Archer Better BF, What the hell are you Canelo doesn't fight at 175. He never campaigned at 175 pounds. Canelo Alvarez had one fight at 175 to win a belt in another division, to make history, to become the fourth Mexican in history to win a belt in four divisions. So because Canelo Alvarez wants to make history, because he wants to add to his legacy, and he picks a one-off fight in a higher weight class, you want him to fight another guy at the weight? Because, oh, now he's scared of this guy? These narratives don't stop. But the interesting thing is, Canelo Alvarez has already come out to Yahoo Sports and Kevin Ioli stating that when they were looking for an opponent at 175, he reached out to Archer Beterbiev to get that smoke. Beterbiev is the one who had plans. Beterbiev is the one who was booked. So it was never Canelo Alvarez fearing anybody at the weight. Let's be honest and unbiased. Tim the Hater Bradley does not want to give Canelo credit, because men lie, women lie, but the facts don't lie.